Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Park Shore Waikiki, our base, home base here on the east end of Waikiki, right across from where Sunset on the Beach took place. And we're about to embark on a day-long Around the Island Lost Locations tour, visiting locations all over the island where ABC's hit TV series Lost was filmed. There's going to be a number of great high points, Byodoin Temple. We're going to visit the Othersville or New Otherton out in Mokuleia, come straight down the center and go through downtown and see a lot of other locations as well. We've never done anything like this before. We're a little bit scared, my wife in particular, but we're among friends. It's basically a big road trip with Lost Geek, so I think we're going to have a good time. Come along. No good. He's moving on before we understood. He shot the future in the foot with every step it took. But from the places that it did, cause he forgot to look. Better staple it together and call it fair weather. Staple it together and call it. We're at the Hawaii Convention Center, otherwise known as the Sydney Airport. One of the first and iconic major locations in Lost. And so hopefully everyone's going to get a thrill traveling internationally just by getting off a bus. Well, I guess you could say that he don't even know where to begin. Because he looked both ways, but he was so afraid. Okay, I'll tell you right now, the Papailoa Beach set is the iconic beach set, but it is way set back from the street. The reason why they moved there from their original location was because it's behind private property. We are crossing Alawai Canal, and right here behind the convention center, this walkway is where Sun and Jin met for the very first time in Korea. It is also where Susan brought Walt to meet Michael, I guess during a custody moment. But right there is where John Locke fell. The house you're going to see is Locke's father's mansion, where he staked out in front of it, and there was a guardhouse. That guardhouse isn't actually there. They brought it out, put it out in there. And he's just watching him in his rearview mirror and just stalking his dad, and then his dad just jumps into the car. That was actually filmed on this street. So I'm just trying to see. There's going to be a couple of lions out in front of the house. That's how you know you've moved into ridiculous tech territory, because who really needs lions in front of their house? On the hill, sort of, is Hurley's mom's mansion. The house that he bought for his mom that immediately caught fire and that he got arrested, and where they parked that red-yellow Hummer in front is going to be on your left. I think, like I said, Daniel Day Kim has been great, and he wants to, you know, his kids go to local schools, and he's just great. When you talk to the cast and crew, apart from the fact that they'll occasionally run into freaks like us, they like Hawaii because, unlike Hollywood, it's just a completely different experience for them. They're not mobbed by TMZ. They're not, you know, we're pretty low-key. I don't know how many of the cast and crew I've seen, and you don't even say anything. You're just like, oh, you know, there they are. But you don't interrupt their day, and they love that. They really love that. If you look kind of down, I mean, you'll recognize some of these rocks. So, too bad he became a prisoner of his own past. He stabbed a moment in the back with the brown thumbtack that held up the list of things he gotta do. It's really no good. He's moving on before he understood. He shot the future. Windward Community College. You may know this grassy sized hill looking campus as the Santa Rosa Mental Health Institute. So the tree under which Charlie meets Hurley, that building, that park bench, the bench and tables are actually there. You can go there and have a breakfast or a brunch there yourself.
Well, I guess you could say.
We are at Byodoin Temple. Beautiful, beautiful site, but it is known and lost as a Korean temple where Sun's father owns a palatial estate, and we even saw it very recently at the very end of season 5, where Jacob went to visit Sun and Jin when they got married. Unfortunately, the water's not blue thanks to the rain we've got, but that's the Paula Ferry Pier out there in the water. They've taken down the little house at the end, it looks like. The roof is just lying on the ground.
It's a private
pier.
He became a prisoner of his own past. He stabbed a moment in the back with the round thumbtack that held up the list of things he gotta do.
Aloha, we're
We're now at Kualoa Ranch, one of the major and main filming locations for Lost, a multi-acre site which has been everything from Hurley's golf course to the camp with the Jughead bomb, everything. There's so much property and so many filming locations here, not just for Lost, but for other movies, that they have movie tours on their own running around here. You might in fact wish you went with them instead of us, but it's a pretty good place to visit on your own. Take a tour around there and see where 51st Dates or where Jurassic Park or Wind Talkers was filmed. It's all definitely here. We're going to be having lunch at the Visitor Center, a great buffet, but then we're going to start on phase two. So this is, of course, Dillingham Airfield, our only airfield out on this side of the island. So not surprisingly, this was the airport in Nigeria where Mr. Echo met with his brother and he got shot. And Mr. Echo ended up on that airplane and it did in fact take off from this field.
He shot the future and the foot with every step it took. But from the places that it did, cause he forgot to look. Better staple it together and call it fair weather. Staple it together and call it fair weather. Staple it together.
Aloha and welcome to Camp Erdman, a very popular youth camp. My daughter loves to stay here, but these cabins are immediately recognizable as New Otherton or Othersville, the surprisingly suburban home of the Others on the island as revealed in season two. Ben Linus's cabin was back there, Sawyer when he was the security guard. Basically, you might in fact still see the playground that was here. And the interesting thing about this is that these cabins were falling apart until Lost got a hold of them. They renovated them and won an award, but then they needed to show Othersville like 30 years and dilapidated. They had to make them all dirty and cover them with grime, and then they had to go back in time and repaint everything. So these poor cabins have been up and down many, many times, but it's an iconic set and they're going to be using it for season 6. Of our driver will be tested in the canyons of Honolulu. On the left, those formal, this pink building, that was the police station where Sawyer was hauled in season one. It was not a bridal shop then. This walking pedestrian mall, this is Whitmore Industries, where Desmond comes out and throws down his tie and sees Charlie standing right here on the corner, and then up ahead to the right, that grassy field you see there, is where Saeed and his brother played soccer. It was the hotel desk in Tunisia. It was also the mosque where Saeed goes to pray. That brick building up that you see up ahead, and it'll be on the right. In there was Charlie's flat with his brother. And they also filmed very briefly out here on the street. So that's here on your right. This is where he steps out in front of the city bus.
Became a prisoner of his own past. He stabbed a moment in the back with the round thumbtack that held up.
Aloha everybody. Well, we did it. We survived and we only got lost toward the end on our Lost Locations tour around the entire island of Oahu. The very first and very last that I'm going to be doing. 61 stops, points of interest, not stops, but we started with a list of 120, so I think we did pretty good whittling it down to spend the entire day. We returned here to the Park Shore, our home base, right across the street from where the sunset on the beach took place. If you're interested in seeing some Lost Locations, well, this is the only place you can be here in Honolulu, but thanks for coming along.
Well, I guess you could say that he don't even know where to begin, because he looked both ways, but he was so well.